Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are fine. From last few days we are discussing the three questions which king wanted, the three questions which the king wanted the answers. And today we are going to see the answers of these three questions. So let us see what are the answers of these three questions. Okay, yesterday what we saw, we saw that a wounded man come towards the hermit and the king, and then the king served him, and the next morning the wounded man tell him the fact. What was the fact? That the wounded man was actually the enemy of the king, but the king was not aware that this person is his enemy, and that is why that wounded man becomes surprised. The king was surprised to know all these things. Okay, and then the wounded man told him the entire fact. What is the fact? And what is the fact? So let us see the fact. So he informed him that I knew, I'm on page number 86. Okay, so informed him that I knew you had gone alone to see the hermit, and I made up my mind to kill you on your way home. But the day passed and you did not return, so I left my hiding place. And I came upon your bodyguard and recognized me, and wounded man wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. I wished to kill you and you saved my life. Now, if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant, and I will order my sons to do the same. Forgive me. Now what happened? The wounded man revealed the fact. What was the fact? Yesterday, let us start from the yesterday. What was the fact? The fact was, sometimes the king means in the past, the king killed the brother, or he executed the brother of this wounded man. And the wounded man actually, or the stranger man actually, wanted to take the revenge of that, and for that purpose he came there. But king was not aware about that. Okay, now how he got wounded or how he got injured, so he is telling now. He said, I knew that you wanted the answer of three questions, and I knew that you were going to come to hermit to know the answers of three questions, and I thought that this is the right opportunity for me to kill you, because I knew that you were going alone to the hermit's hut. And so what I did, so I was hiding myself in the bushes, and I was waiting for you, and I thought, or I made a plan, that when you will come back, at that time what will I do? I will attack on you and I will kill you, because I knew that you will be without weapons during that time. But what happened? Throughout the day I waited for you, but you went to the hermit's king and you did not came back. Throughout the day you were, you know, until sunset you did not come. So I became confused that what is the reason that king is not coming back. And to see that, I came out of the bushes, and during that time what happened, your bodyguards saw me, they noticed me and they recognized me. They came to know that he is the enemy of the king and he can kill the king, and they chased me and injured me. They attacked on me and they injured me, but anyway I escaped from them, and I started running towards you. In the evening I came to you, and then I became fainted, I become unconscious, but you dressed my wounds, you served me, and because of you only I am alive today. Then he felt very bad for that, and that's why he was saying, ki forgive me. And what he's saying that I decided to kill you, I wished to kill you, but you saved my life, and that is why I'm feeling very, very shameful on that. And I decided now that I will be the most faithful servant of yours. Throughout the life I will serve you. Not only that, even I will tell my sons to serve you throughout their life. Okay, and in this way the wounded man, the stranger, revealed the fact that who is he. Now the king was very happy to have made a peace with his enemy so easily and have won him over as a friend. He not only forgave him but said he would send servants and his own doctors to look after him. And he promised me to give back to man's to give back the man's property. Now what happened? When the king came to know all these things, the king became very happy. Why king became very happy? That king, you know, very easily, actually king made a peace with his enemy. Very easily means without doing any efforts. Just he served the person and he became his servant now. And that's why he felt very happy. And he even came to know that the man's brother was not guilty. Still the king executed him. And that's why the king decided to forgive that man. Okay. And the king did not only forgive him, but also he decided, what he decided that he will, because the man is injured now, so he will tell his servant, he will tell his doctors, means the royal doctor we can say, or he will tell the king's doctor to serve the wounded man. Not only that, he promised the wounded man that he will return his property also. And in that way, what happened? The man was also very happy and king was also very happy. In that way, that incident was over. Now, after satisfying the stranger man, the wounded man, now king realized that he has to go back because his bodyguards and his army was waiting for him. So he came out of the hut. And what he saw? He saw that leaving the wounded man behind, the king went out of the hut and looked around for a hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to get the answers to the questions. The hermit was on his knees sowing seeds in the beds that he had been dug the day before. The king went up to the hermit and said, "For the last time, I beg you to answer my three questions, wise man." "You already been answered," said the hermit, still bending down to the ground and looking up the king as he stood before him. How have I been answered? What did you mean? Now what happened? The king came out of the hut and now he was almost ready to go back because he felt that the hermit even cannot answer his three questions. But still he thought before going, last time let me ask the answers. Let me ask the hermit the answers of my three questions. And he went to the hermit. And what hermit was doing? Actually, hermit was bending and he was sowing some seeds on the beds which king digged yesterday. Okay. And very politely the king asked. What king asked? What king said? The king said, wise hermit, one last time I would like to ask you the answers of my three questions. If you really want to give the answers, you can give, otherwise I am going. At the time the hermit was doing, so hermit was still sowing the seeds, and hermit replied at that time, that morning. And what hermit said, actually you have already been answered. What he said? You have already been answered. Means the hermit said that I have already given the answers of your three questions. And the king did not understand. The king said, what? You gave the answers of my three questions when? So he did not understand. And he is asking when it is answered. Now the hermit is explaining him how he answered the three questions of the hermit. Now see. Do you not see, replied the hermit, if you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug these beds for me, you would have gone away. Then that man would have attacked you and you would have wished you had stayed with me. So the most important time was when you were digging the beds. And I was the most important man, and to do me good was your most important business. Now what is the right time, what is the right man, and what is the right thing? Now the hermit was explaining, you know, what is the right time. He said, yesterday you came, you asked me the answers, but I did not reply. Okay. So what you did, you waited for the right time so that I can answer. Then you felt pity on me And as a result, what happened? You started digging the beds. Because if you did not wait, you did not wait there and you did not help me to dig the beds, you might have gone back and that man might have attacked you, and today you would not be there in this world. Okay, and what you did? So you waited there and you were digging the beds. So he says, from this we can conclude, what we can conclude, that what is the right time? Yesterday, the right time, the time which you were waited, okay, that was the right time. And who was the most important person? I was the most important person yesterday. And not only that, the beds which you were digging, that was the most important thing for you. Okay, so this was the answer. Afterwards, when the man ran to us, the most important time was when you were caring for him, because if you had not dressed his wounds, he would have died without having made peace with you. And he says that after that, who was the most important person for you? Sorry, most important thing for you? Sorry, what is the most important time? So he said afterwards, in the evening, what happened? The wounded man came and you were serving. Okay, so that serving that wounded man, that was the most important time for you. Okay, let us read this first, then we will come to know. So that was the most important man, and what you did for him was your most important business. So he said yesterday the time which you were serving the wounded man, that time was the most important time or the right time for you. And who was the most important person for you in the evening? The most important person was that man. And what is the most important business? To serve that man was the most important business. Now, why all this? He said, because if you did not do all that things yesterday, then that man might have killed means, sorry, died. And without making peace with your enemy, that man would have died, and you never came to know what was the problem with that man and who was that man. And that is why yesterday, the right time was when you were what is that? You waited there, and the right person was the man who to whom you were serving, and the right time was you were dressing or you were nursing that man. Okay, and that is why what he says, the finally he gave the answer. He says, remember, then there is only one time that is important, and that time is now. He says, what is the most important time in one's life or anyone's life is the time now, at present. What is the most important time? At present. Now, this is the most important time for me and you also. Okay? It is the most important time because it is the only time when we have power to act. Why this time is the most important time? Because at this time we have the power. Power means at that time we can do whatever we want to do. We don't know in future we will be there or not. In past we cannot do the things. And this is the right time. The most necessary person in the is the person you are with the particular moment. For no one knows what will happen in the future and whether we will meet anyone else. And this is at that time, means at this time, who is the most important person? The person who are with us. The person who are with us. Now for you, I am the most important person, and for me, you are the most important person. Okay, so who is the most person in important person in someone's life? Who are at this time with us? Because we don't know in future they will be there or not, and in past, of course, there is no possibility. The most important business is to do that person's good, because we were sent into this world for the purpose only, and to do the good to the person or the people who are with us, or the most important person, is the right thing in anyone's life, is the right business in anyone's life. Okay, so these were the answers of the three questions. The video is already too big, so let us stop here. Thank you very much. Do the exercise, and if you feel any problem in that, then you can contact me and you can tell me. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.